First abiotic one we're going to look at is temperature. Temperature, you've got two extremes. One is high temperature, one is low temperature. If the temperature gets too high for the plant, it's not good. If it gets too low for the plant, that's a problem as well. When we look at low temperature, we could talk about freeze injury, we could talk about chilling injury, we can talk about super chilling. Freeze injury means that you have to have the formation of ice crystals on the inside of it. Therefore, the temperature must drop below the freezing point of the cytoplasm. Chilling injury is where you have the temperature dropping below a specific number which would allow damage to occur to the plant. When we're looking at chilling injury, we may be looking at anything below 45 degrees Fahrenheit or about 8 degrees Celsius if we are talking about a tropical type plant, or we may be looking at something at a lower temperature than that. We also have what we call super chilling. Super chilling occurs when the temperature of the cytoplasm drops below that of freezing. However, there is no place for nucleation of ice crystals to occur. I saw this once in class. Basically, they had super chilled a plant down to a temperature around 26 degrees Fahrenheit. Nothing really happened, and all of a sudden, somebody put up a vibration. You could hear the ice crystals forming, and you could hear the cracking going on inside of the plant. It was pretty scary. When you look at golf greens and golf courses, they don't want you walking across the grass when the first frost hits because the tissue of the grass hasn't necessarily frozen yet. If you walk on it, you will cause that super chilled grass to actually nucleate ice. As you do that, you've got destruction of that particular material. This is the USDA plant hardiness zone map. It gives you the average annual minimum temperature in a region. And this is quite important to understand because you have different temperatures in here based on what is normal in certain areas. You can see that the north central part of the United States is quite cold as far as low temperatures go, whereas down around Florida, it's not nearly as cold. If you look at the panhandle of Florida, the average annual minimum temperature is somewhere between 15 and 20 degrees Fahrenheit. You would not expect things like that in Florida because everybody thinks that Florida is tropical. Panhandle is kind of subtropical. We look at this map in order to determine where we really get this cold coming in compared to other areas. You've got two pictures here. One is of an orange that has frozen on the inside of it. When it freezes on the inside, it destroys the cells. You don't get the proper formation of juice. This is a freeze injury. You've got chilling injury on this other plant. Looks like an African violet, where you can see the circles on the leaves where you have had excessive amounts of chilling occur. This becomes quite interesting to look at. These are extremes in temperature, high temperature, low temperature.